The moment I hit the stage, I've never felt more like me. Everything I've ever wanted to be or dreamed of being is Trixie Minx on stage as a burlesque performer.
Everyone's there with all their ideas, and burlesque dancers are like Boy Scouts of America, can make like costume out of like a safety pin and like a broken necklace, you know?
My burlesque habit supports itself. As they say, I use all my burlesque earnings, put back into costumes and rhinestones and all the things.
It's really amazing and inspiring to be around these different women. It really kind of helps me figure out who I am, you know, and not just in the praline sense, but in the everyday.
Like, I'm a very selfish performer. A lot of people are like, it's for the audience, the world, the crowd is what gets me. I'm like, I'm up there for me. Like, I'm having fun. I'm doing this for me. I built this prop. I want to show it off. I'm doing this for me.
Burlesque is very glamorous to most people with the naked eye because they don't realize what happens behind the scenes. They think, oh, these women, they're gorgeous, they're beautiful, they're on stage. And many of us have burlesque life and day life.
I work 5 days a week. I'll be a second grade teacher in August. My job doesn't know that I'm a burlesque performer.
Some people just don't get it and they don't realize like it's a production. It is an art. It's supposed to be a little anarchy. It took me a while to be comfortable with myself and what I like to do and what type of person I am. And I feel pretty good about it at this point. If you don't like it, like, whatever.
I had a very negative body image while I was doing ballet, and through burlesque, I'm healthier now. For years, I was like, oh God, I'm fat, I'm ugly, I'm horrible. I was apparently a hot chick. Who knew?
The whole burlesque scene, it's created by women, it's created by us, and I think what strip clubs do to take away women's power, burlesque gives back, and I feel like they're polar opposites.
We can convert people in shows, you know, they might come in sort of hesitant, they just don't understand what we do, but by the time they leave, they're smiling and having a great time, and we've totally converted them. They're like, this is really fun, and I see that you're trying to like help women feel good about themselves.
I produced 3 New Orleans-based shows. Fleur de Tease, New Orleans' premier variety burlesque show. But the one-eyed Jack.
Trixie Minx. She's in it on a number of levels. As like a producer, as like a performer, as like a choreographer. She's fantastic. I gig with her a lot. She gets me a lot of gigs.
You know, there are like these figureheads, especially like in New Orleans burlesque, and those would be Trixie Minx, Roxy Rouge. They're like the ultimate.
2 years ago, I started my own show called Big Deal Burlesque. It's predominantly a touring show, so I take the best performers from New Orleans and guests from all over the country on the road. And I started producing a New Orleans-based show, which is at Siberia once a month.
It's very frequent for our audience to be mostly young women.
This crowd and this kind of thing is exactly why I do what I do.
Roxy's really nurturing and really positive, but at the same time, she won't take any of your shit.
New Orleans has a very embracive burlesque community, but there's some people that don't play nice, and it's interesting to see how the performers still rise above the pettiness. We all come together because we love what we do, and that's what bonds us together, which is pretty fucking awesome.
Burlesque is for everybody. If you have breath in your lungs and you can get on stage and you can own it and you can entertain someone, then you belong in burlesque. And that's why I'm here.
I guess there's like something that clicked in my head. This is what I'm destined to do. I think I get emotional about it because with doing ballet for so long, people told me I would never be a dancer, or I wasn't good enough. And they beat me up about it, you know? And luckily, I'm a shithead, and I was like, I'm gonna prove all you wrong, so.
Put your hands together, then, for Roxy LaRue.
My name is Roxy LaRouge. Shoe salesman by day, burlesque dancer by night. I've been here all my life. I took only ballet until high school, and then I went to New Orleans Center for Creative Arts for high school, so I wound up taking modern and tap and kind of focused on choreography and producing my own shows. There's a special energy here. For me, I'm in love with it, and I can't see myself anywhere else. Growing up as a dancer, I was always told that I had to live in New York if I wanted to make it as a dancer, and until a couple of years ago, I thought that I would move. But watching everything that happened with Katrina, I decided that I was gonna stay and carve my own niche. Never take the easy road, I always just try to take the right one.
I'm an attention whore. Like, I like to be on stage. Like, just give me a stage, put me on it. I don't care, like, if I didn't rehearse before, because I never rehearsed before, hardly ever. Maybe I should change that. Turn down for what? Yeah, I'm a gardener during the day. I serve coffee. These are my other jobs, because I feel like to be a real burlesquer, you have to have at least like four jobs, right? I tend to like just fall into things, you know, and then work my way from there. Like, oh, this seems like a good idea. I don't really know what it is, but let's just fall into it. And then it just turns into something really amazing that's unexpected. And burlesque was definitely one of those things. Plus, you know, like rhinestones and girlfriends and like champagne. That's also really fun.
I don't rehearse because there's a little bit of lack of follow through in my personality. Going to a fleur de tease rehearsal for me is like if you go to your girlfriend's house for a sleepover and then you dance a little bit.
It took me a while to be comfortable with myself and what I like to do and what type of person I am. You're here, you're proud. If you feel good about what you're doing, and I do feel good about what I'm doing, like, you know, like it doesn't matter what you do because someone's always gonna have something to say.
The person on stage is me. Trixie Minx is me unfiltered. Girls, we run this mother. Yeah. Girls, we run this mother. Girls, we run this mother. Yeah. Girls, we run this mother. Girls, girl. Being a producer has a lot of elements to it that I didn't necessarily know I was signing up for. I am a therapist, friend, I'm a shepherd. But not in like a positive way. Basically do everything from the show conception to the coordination of different schedules and egos. And often what I'm left doing is running across the greater New Orleans area, hunting down women to herd them. But they're like cats on crack. They're everywhere. In our community, everybody is super friendly, and one of the great things about burlesque is that it is so embracive of so many different shapes and body sizes. But when it comes to gigs, specific gigs, contracts, there are oftentimes a look that the client's going for, and that's where feelings tend to get hurt. I feel like by making burlesque a business, you have to respect it. It is a business. It's not purely just some girl dancing for fun. On the other end, some people do not want burlesque to be a business, and they actually get upset when people start treating it as such. They think it takes away the artistry. This is what I've noticed the most, is people confuse friendship with a work relationship. The work relationships I have, I like to be friends with the people I work with, but a lot of times, if I have jobs that I don't give to a specific person, they won't even begin to think, well, maybe I'm not the right fit for the job. They'll think, oh, Trixie's mad at me.
A lot of times whenever people think of Ruby Rage, they don't think of a sweet and innocent person because the name is Rage. It's a completely opposite. It's like, oh, Ruby Rage, she's sweet and innocent. She's a little country cutie. Versus, you know, she's Ruby Rage. You know, don't piss her off, which I can say don't piss me off because I do get very upset and I kind of disown people when I do get upset. For a long time, I didn't believe in myself. For a long time, I hated myself. For a very long time, I felt excluded from the world. And then this wonderful creative thing came into my life and it just popped into there and it helped me relearn who I am. I had a purpose, I had creativity, and I could use it in a way that made me happy. The biggest struggle for my burlesque career has been my weight. When I started, I was a lot thinner, and then I gained weight, and then I started losing gigs. There's all these excuses you get, and sometimes you just wish people would just be upfront with you about it. I've definitely cried a lot of nights in my pillows from it, and then stepped back, and I was like, well, I can't handle the women right now. I need to take a break.
I need to become healthy, so I dropped about 30 pounds, been able to do all these changes to benefit me in my health, and that's another thing that is making me happy.
Well, the baby's a chick with the prop side hell. You can't say this baby's a square.
I'm a very selfish performer. I'm up there for me. Like, I'm having fun. I'm doing this for me. I built this prop and I want to show it off. Doing this for me. I keep myself very entertained. If I'm not in a show, I'm going to a show. Like, I have ADD, I have constant need of entertainment, and I will be anywhere from like a drag show to a burlesque show to a concert. Where am I going? What am I doing? I don't know. I need to sit down with like a psychic, maybe just like a tarot card reader, just kind of help. I'm still learning how to be a grown-up. Trixie gives me guidance, but I feel like I need like some more, just something bigger, like that big sign to tell me what I need to do right now. My love life is in a bit of a gray area. I certainly don't talk to my ex-girlfriend anymore. This is the first time I'm ever really dealing with the repercussions of dating someone. It's hard when you live in a small city, though. It's even harder when the lesbian community is about this big. The new girlfriend that is like throwing like heinous negative energy my way, like I'm scared that she's gonna come to a show and boo me. Somehow this could affect my life, even professionally. Been traveling a lot for the show in Atlantic City, and then when I am home, I have shows here, and I still don't have a permanent place to live yet. Until then, I am still on a sofa. So it's just very stressful and exhausting. So what I'm doing in Atlantic City is kind of like as far as you can go. It's like to do a casino show. I'm like hitting this point of like, okay, now what next? How can I top this?
God, my life is a hot mess. I am teaching second grade during the day, planning for my wedding that's in a few months, and on top of that, I've been coming home at night and doing a lot of practice with my fans, because they're very awkward to yield. I have no idea. Trixie and them make it look so effortless and beautiful, but it's not. It hurts. Right now, I'm more concerned about stretching myself. There's definitely some mornings when I wake up and being at school is the last place I want to be. My mom, who is a teacher, is really pressuring me to choose between my teaching career and my burlesque life. She's afraid of what people will think, that it's going to cost me my job. And then on the other side of my family, my future mother-in-law isn't too thrilled by the idea of me being on stage.
It's very frequent for our audience to be mostly young women, because I think you can always kind of picture yourself up on stage, and you get to see a lot of different women, a lot of different body types, all just celebrating what they have in common, and that's just being women.